Hey there, Heather Boyd Wire here, and today I'm making another name out of wire.
Today I'm going to show you how to make a bracelet with the name Mustafa and a little palette. I'm going to use 18 gauge wire for the bracelet and 20 gauge wire for the little palette, and then I have a few little seed beads there. So I have a 20 inch piece of wire, and I'm going to start about 5 inches from the end. And what you want to do is to start forming your letters. I have quite a few name tutorials up already on YouTube. I also have a video coming up with all the cursive letters. So I'll start with the lowercase and then do the uppercase. And so if you have a letter style that you like doing already, that's great. Otherwise, there are other tutorials online where you could figure out how to do the letters. So we'll just start with the M. So we're going to just start forming the top and then bend it up. The 18 gauge is very stiff to work with, but for the bracelet I think it's a good idea to use something that's quite solid, so we're just going to work around with that. You can always practice on a wire that's a little thinner for sure. So there's the M, and then we're just going to bring the wire up. The tricky part, of course, is to get all the letters the right size, but just do your best for that. So there's the M, and then we want to bring the wire to the front and just give it a good pinch. And then for the U, I'm going to use a slightly larger round plier just to get a larger loop there. So just bring that up and then to the back again. So you want to like vary bending to the front and the back depending what the letter is. And then for the cursive S, we're going to bring this up. And then it's really going to look like a traditional cursive S. So we're going to bring this and hold the with your pliers, bend this to the front, push it down. It's very stiff, but like I said, I think it's a good idea if you want to make the whole bracelet out of wire to have a good stiff wire. So there's the S, and then we're going to bend it across, and that forms the cursive S. And then if you need to adjust it, you can just adjust it. And then we want the T. So for the T, bring it across and then bring this up. And then what you want to do is figure out your height and bend this to the back, hold it, bend it to the back. And then we need our cross wire. So what you'll do is take this, hold it in place, and bend it across here and flip it again. And now you want to bend the wire to the front so you can cross over the T. So that forms the cross. And then we're going to bend this to the back and bring this down. So for the A, we want to bring it across. Okay, bring it right across here and get your larger pliers to form the circle. So, and bring the wire to the back for the A because you're going to have to cross over it again. So just do a circle, adjust the size, look at your other letters, adjust the size if you have to, and close your circle, and then bring this all the way up behind the circle, going straight up vertical. Okay, just go straight up like that. Now, because it's so stiff, I would definitely use the pliers to help it over here. Otherwise, you can do it with your fingernail, but it's going to be really stiff. So take that and push it down over the side of the A. Okay, and then for the F, we're going to bring this around, and it's going to be like making an L. So we'll hold this in place, bring that up, and then form this loop here about the height you want. Could be like around the same as the T. Bring that down. Now for the cursive F, what I like to do is just hold it here underneath, bring it up, okay? And you can always look at a cursive alphabet on Google as well, or like I said, I have a video coming up with all the letters. So we're gonna go there and then bend it across, and then all you're going to need is the other A. So we'll take our larger round pliers again, bring it to the back, and make sure it's about, you know, the same size. Bring it all the way to the back, straight up. And again, you're going to need help to bring it over. So just take your round pliers, give it a little pinch, push it down, and then bring that across. So now we have Mustafa's name. There we go. Super cool. Now the question is how we do the bracelet, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to attach the palette in a different way. I'm going to just use a separate wire for that. So what you want to do is start to form. We'll just finish off the bracelet for now. So just with your finger, kind of like go like this to get it started the circle around. And even this part, you want to curve the name, especially if it's a long name, you want to curve it around a little bit so it'll kind of go around the shape of the wrist. And then what I like to do is take a round form, here's some pill bottles, and just bring them around. Okay, this one is, the wire is higher, so let's bring it underneath. And then we're going to bring this one, or actually bring it over top, and then bring this one around here. So this is just to get the round part started. And then what I did was I made a little template. Basically, it's sort of a circle. And apparently, like 6 millimeter diameter is good for women, kids 5 millimeter, and men 6.5 millimeter. This is approximate. It really depends on the size of your wrist. So what I would do for that is bring it here and center the name. You can draw a circle, like I just traced a pill bottle or something. So just bring it here, match it up to your circle, and then you want these bends to be sort of an equal distance type of thing. So probably what I should have done is done like a center point here. So imagine the center point where these are, and then just, you can start it off by just doing like a little bend. So just start it by doing like a little bend here, and then come over here and you just do like a little bend here. So you have a like a little idea of where these bends should be. And then what you want to do is actually come over here, bring it around, and you want to loop it around, but it's going to be tricky because it's a hard wire. So just bring it up, let's remove this. Hold this with your round pliers, bend it down in here, okay? And then you're gonna be able to kind of bend it up here. So same thing over here. So this one's underneath. So this one we wanna bend around. So let's just bring it here, hold it with your pliers, start your round circle. It's just easier if you start it with the pliers and then bend this up. So you have a couple of options here. You could just clip it, but I think it's going to be better if you actually wind it around a couple of times. So otherwise it's going to slip. So hold it with your pliers and then just bring it around a couple of times here. Okay, so I have three there. Let's do this one. We're going to go around here and let's just see how it works. So then you're going to fiddle around with it and see how, you know, this part works, if it's tight enough for you. If you feel you need it a little more tight, you can do more springs on there. You're going to have to experiment to see what works with the wire that you're using. And then you want to clip it like really tightly in there. So clip one side and then clip the other side. Try to have the clips so they're not against the skin. And then you can just kind of pinch them in a little bit, not too much because you don't want it like squishing the wire so it's not able to move it. You can get a little file and file those little ends if you need to. If you can push them kind of underneath a little bit as well. And then this is going to be adjustable. So when you put it on, you can do that. And then you're going to have to like close it up. So then you'll figure out, you know, how big your wrist is, and then you're going to close it up that way there. So this is just going to take a little bit of experimenting. It depends on your wire. It could get a little distorted. So you could definitely play around with that. And then now we want to do the little palette. I thought it would be cute. So let's just take our thinner wire. And this is an experiment. I haven't tried it like this before. So we're going to see if it's going to work. And what I like to do always is start like the circle with the pliers first. So we have the curve. I'm just going to put the beads on there. We've got some red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and I don't have purple, so I'm just going to go with a darker blue. So there we go. So we have some colors to represent the palette, and you know, we'll have to open up this a little bit. And then let's just bring it around here. We don't want it too big, because this is like a little dangling charm. And we're going to bring that one up. And then over here, we're going to start to form this around here. Okay, we're just going to bring it right around here. And then we want to twist it right around in a circle around the top. So we're going to bring it around here. Okay, and then I'm going to bring it here. And then we want to, what I usually do when I do the palettes, I just kind of make like a little kind of symbolic loop here to represent the thing that goes, you put your thumb in. And then to make the actual paintbrushes, we're going to take this one and bend it over here. And we can form, like make kind of a little paintbrush thing. It's going to be a little fragile, because you know, the wires can get a little caught up and stuff, but I think it's cute, it's unique. So we're going to bring this back and form the little brush here, and then you need to kind of twist that around. So it's really tricky to twist when it's so small, so just get your pliers and bring it around here. And I probably should have maybe done the palette a little bigger, but we're just gonna deal with it like this. So we're gonna go here and then bring this underneath. We can have, you can even have one color on one side, and then just bend this here and cut it flush there. There we go. So we're just gonna bend that one to the back. I think that's too many beads. So I'm gonna actually just remove one. This is a real hack. We're just gonna take this bead here and I just cut it off. That's a real cheat, but it just gives me a little more wiggle room. And so then from there, you could add it with a jump ring on there if you liked, or you can actually add it, like actually make your loop and add it on. So I'm going to try it that way, where I'm just going to add it right on, because I don't want it to be too fragile. So I'm going to form the loop here and then just decide where I want to hang it. Like I could hang it on the F, but that might be a little low. So I think I'm just going to hang it right beside here, and it can definitely wiggle around. It's all good. And so we're going to attach that. So we want to close the loop. We're just going to take this and bring it around and close the loop here. There you go. And then take this and bring it right around to make a complete loop. And then you'll want to make another brush. So we could just bring it down from the top. Okay, bring it down with your nail. You can use the pliers if you need. And I'm going to, this one got a little twisted. So I'm going to do the same thing where I form another little brush. This is really teeny tiny. It's kind of tricky to do. If you have a easier way to make the little ends of the paintbrush that aren't so big, go for it. It's just the concept, you know, you guys can play around with it. And of course you can put any charm on here. Like you can dangle beads, you can dangle any kind of like heart beads, any kinds of beads you want on here. Like once you have your name bracelet done down, you can add whatever you like. So there's the other brush. Very, very tiny. It's probably hard for you guys to see. But we're going to hold it and bring this around and around here. Okay. And then as we did before, we want to attach it. to the palette in a way that it's going to stay put. And so we're just going to basically bring this wire to the back. So let me just see the best way to attach it. Yeah, so that one's over there, and we can do the same thing where we just bring it to the back, cut the end. Because when it's so small, it's really hard to like twist the wire around many times. So it's almost better just to cut the wire, bend it in, and then it's sort of like tucked in behind there. So let's see it up close. Super cute, really tiny. This special one for Mustafa. And there we go. So we have Mustafa's name. We have the little dangling palette. And if you don't like it, how it goes across like that, we can fix that. And just bend it down and bend this up. This will be like a little loop down there. And we're just going to bend that out so it just creates its own little loop for it to sit in. And that way you don't have to worry about it sliding back and forth. We just create a little loop here. And you know, if you need the loop a little bigger, just open it up and you can wiggle it around with it just to get, it's just so it has like somewhere to dangle. That works better. Then it's like not gonna go anywhere. And there we have Mustafa bracelet with a little palette.
So thanks so much for watching the video. Give it a big thumbs up if you liked it. Be sure to subscribe to my channel for lots more DIY wire art and jewelry making videos. Hit the notification bell to be notified when I go live and when I post new videos. And be sure to comment below and let me know if you make some names out of wire. See you the next time.